Hello, Reverend Vicky here from St James's Church Southam, and welcome to this week's online worship. We're continuing to look at the fruit of the Spirit from Galatians 5, and this week we're looking at goodness. Let's start with some verses from the Psalms. Psalm 34, verse 8. Taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the one who takes refuge in him. And Psalm 100, verses 4 and 5. Enter his gates with thanksgiving and his courts with praise. Give thanks to him and praise his name. For the Lord is good and his love endures forever. His faithfulness continues through all generations. So let's join together in praise of our good God through that lovely hymn, All Things Bright and Beautiful. Lord, you are good, and your goodness knows no bounds. When we were lost, you sought us out, found us, and brought us home. When we were alone, you came near to us, and you gave us a new circle of friends and family. Each breath we take, each sunrise we see, each heartbeat we feel, and each song we sing or hear, all are gifts from you. Yet we've grown complacent in our blessings, taking them for granted rather than as signs of your grace, keeping them for ourselves rather than using them to bless others. Forgive our selfish hearts and closed fists. Forgive our self-importance that leads us to take ourselves too seriously, to take you too lightly, and to forget others altogether. Forgive us when we're too embarrassed to name you out loud. Open our eyes to see the goodness of your love and the costly gift of our forgiveness. Renew us and help us to be all you created us to be. In Jesus' name, Amen. Psalm 25. Remember, Lord, your great mercy and love, for they are from of old. Do not remember the sins of my youth and my rebellious ways. According to your love, remember me, for you, Lord, are good. Amen.
Sing of the Lord's goodness, Father of all wisdom, come to him and bless his name.
Mercy he has shown us, his love is forever faithful to the end of days.
Come then, all you nations, sing of the Lord's goodness, melodies of praise and thanks to God. Bring out the Lord's glory, praise him with your music, worship him and bless his name.
Spoken, one bread he has broken, new life he now gives to all.
Come then, all you nations, sing of the Lord's goodness, melodies of praise and thanks to God. Bring out the Lord's glory, praise him with your music, worship him and bless his name.
Most High,
solace for the weary,
pardon for the sinner,
splendor of the living God.
Come then, all you nations, sing of the Lord's goodness, melodies of praise and thanks to God. Ring out the Lord's glory, praise him with your music, worship him and bless his name.
Our reading today is the parable of the sower, which can be found in Matthew chapter 13, Mark chapter 1 and Luke chapter 8. But today we're going to have our Bible story through a video. I hope that you enjoy.
Stories of the Bible. The parable of the farmer. This is Jesus.
Heyo!
Who is the Son of God and the Savior of the world. While Jesus was on earth, he taught everyone about God's love. He healed many people from their sickness, performed many miracles like calming storms, and even raised people from the dead.
Wahoo!
One day, Jesus went and sat beside the sea. A great crowd gathered around him.
Oh, hey, everyone.
So he got in a boat and told them many things in parables.
Okay, listen to this.
He told them this story. A farmer went out to plant some seed. As he scattered it across his field, some of the seed fell on a footpath where it was stepped on, and the birds came and ate it. Other seed fell on shallow soil among rocks. The seed began to grow quickly because the soil was shallow, but the plant soon wilted under the hot sun, and since it didn't have deep roots, it died. Other seed fell among thorns that grew up and choked out the tender plants. Still, other seed fell on fertile soil. This seed grew and produced a crop that was 100 times as much as had been planted. When Jesus had said this, he called out, "Anyone with ears to hear should listen and understand."
Yeah?
Later, the disciples came to Jesus and asked what this parable meant. Jesus said, "The farmer plants seed by taking God's word to others. The seed that fell on the footpath represents those who hear the message, only to have Satan come at once and take it away. The seed on the rocky soil represents those who hear the message and immediately receive it with joy. But since they don't have deep roots, they don't last long. They fall away as soon as they have problems or are treated badly for believing God's word. The seed that fell among the thorns represents others who hear God's word, but all too quickly the message is crowded out by the worries of this life and the desire for other things. And the seed that fell on good soil represents those who hear and accept God's word and produce a harvest of 30, 60, or even 100 times as much as had been planted."
I wonder what you describe as good. Good or goodness is a value. Something is good when it does what it says on the tin, or when it makes something better or right. A good meal is one that satisfies, well cooked and full of goodness for our health. A good book is one we've enjoyed reading, perhaps with a good twist or interesting characters. We're told to be good. The Greek word in the Bible means an uprightness of heart and life. Therefore, being good is an action that is beneficial to you and to others. As we look at the Bible, good or goodness runs through it. In Genesis, God created a very good world. Although fallen, our world is still good, although damaged by evil. All that is good is from God. Indeed, the word comes from the Old English word, godness, meaning it has something of God inherent in an action or a thing. Therefore, is it any wonder that we see God's love and care, an amazing detail around us in creation? It makes sense from that biblical beginning where God's creation is good, because it contains godness. And the pinnacle of creation, people, specifically carry that image of God and share in his work in relationship with him. Goodness is not as our possession, but as his gift. In the Psalms, God is good because his love endures forever. Even through struggles and trials, God is good. His love never fails. His mercies are new every morning. then Jesus is called good teacher, one that people enjoy hearing, find stimulating, and who teaches valuable lessons. Jesus is called good shepherd because he laid down his life for the sheep. He was selfless. Jesus's actions were good for the benefit of others. The cross, healing, deliverance, combating the power of sin. There is something about life in goodness. So we come to our reading that describes a sower and the different types of ground the seed falls on. We recognise the times of hardness when the seed of God's message of love cannot penetrate, and the distractions that take our attentions away from it so quickly. How often does the phone ring or a message pop in just as we're about to pray or read the Bible? We recognise too the cares and worries of the world. There seems so much anxiety and more ahead of us at the moment, and it so easily chokes that message of love because we're struggling. But some seeds fall on good soil, soil that receives and is ready to see growth. There's just the right conditions to produce a harvest. And we think we aren't like that very often. But don't forget that even in this fallen world, God created you and said you are very good. You carry that image, that gift from God, to reflect his goodness in our lives in all kinds of ways. We see it in Jesus's example, not just in his stories, but in his life and ministry, and in his promise that we can be the same, overflowing with the goodness of God. There is something about life in goodness. We have the God-given potential to grow in goodness, to increase in purposeful and creative maturing. We need to encourage one another to bring goodness into the world. Being good flows out of the spirit of goodness, which is a fruit of the spirit outlined in Galatians chapter 5, verse 22. Goodness is the rightly ordered motivation behind our desire to act well, and it prioritises what God desires: the love of others, rightness, justice, and mercy. I wonder how many times we were told as children to be good. It was probably in a situation where we had to behave and mind our manners. But here in our passage, we're encouraged to receive the gift that Jesus offers so we can grow in the fruit of God's goodness in and through our lives. Because there's something about life, life in all of its fullness, in God's goodness.
Look at the world and what will it bring.
Let's pray together, and each prayer will end, Lord, in your goodness. And let's respond together, hear our prayer. So, Lord, in your goodness, hear our prayer. Lord, you created the universe and everything in it. You know every line, every curve of this beautiful planet. And you already know how the story will end. We ask you to give us wisdom to care for our earthly home and walk in peace, knowing we have an eternal home with you. Lord, in your goodness, hear our prayer. Lord, we know you see the unrest as nations rise against each other. You grieve with those who are hurting and see the needs of those who are suffering. Bring your healing and comfort where it's needed, and show us where we can bring hope and peace. Lord, in your goodness, hear our prayer. We pray for our nation with the uncertainties of leadership, the struggles of living costs, and the rise of the virus again. We pray for those in the health and care services, for strength and encouragement in what is an exhausting and sometimes thankless task. Lord, in your goodness, hear our prayer. For those who mourn, where loss cuts deep and sadness overwhelms, we pray for your peace. Lord, in your goodness, hear our prayer. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. At the live service at St James's, we have a baptism on Sunday morning. So I hope that you'll forgive me for choosing the final song that we'll sing together. The song words are about us each being unique and thanking God for making us the people that we are. We are each one of a kind, but together we're God's family. I hope that you enjoy it.
I am. I'm God's special child. I'm special.
And don't you forget it. Now how about singing this song?
Yeah, let's sing. Can I start?
Sure, be my guest.
Just thank you, Father, for making me.
Let the majesty of the Father be the light by which you walk. The compassion of the Son be the love by which you walk. The presence of the Spirit be the power by which you walk. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you now and remain with you always. Amen.